What's up, guys? Chase Curtis here. I'm going to be filling in a little bit on this week's Bell Helmets Life on Two Wheels vlog because Donn is on family vacation up in Alaska, I believe. We are heading out to Paula Fox Raceway for some motos with Dommer and the guys from Husqvarna. KTM, Gas, those guys. They're going to be breaking in some 25 bikes, so that'll be cool. I just picked up this bad boy from Yamaha a couple days ago, and I honestly have only rode once, which included like 5 laps since I got released from the surgeon and the doctors. So it's gonna be a slow day, but it's all right. Try to have some fun on some two wheels. So our 2024 YZ2VDF has seen probably 3 different versions. I think three, yeah, three. So if you guys remember, originally this was the throwback edition with the white and the purple accents and all that, which I loved for about 2 weeks. And then I was like, man, I really miss a blue bike. So then I basically made it like all black, blue in the front. I got blue wheels from Yamaha. And yeah, basically made it look like an original YZ2VDF. And while I was hurt, I decided I wanted to go all blue and throw these badass W wheels on. So yeah, that's what we did. All blue with Cherby's plastics. Some new Backyard Designs graphics. Let me know down below what you guys think about the graphics. I spent a good amount of time making them on their website, which was always pretty fun. But yeah, pretty stoked on how it looks right now. This is probably my favorite version that I've done this year. And man, these W wheels are insane. I haven't touched them since they were on my bike last year. And honestly, I was probably pretty lazy with checking spokes on the bike last year. But I went through and checked all the spokes when I put them on this thing, and literally not a single spoke was loose. So that's just pretty nutty to think about. But yeah, all in all, we have Pro Taper ACF bars in the Carmichael bend, which is like a stock Husky bend. I really like flat bars for whatever reason. Extra clamps, Enzo suspension, W wheels, Hinson clutch, Hinson basket, Yoshimura system. And then some FCP engine mounts, front and rear. I haven't had a lot of time logged with these yet. They actually put these on the bike when I was hurt, so interested to get some more track time today and see how they feel. So before they look pretty, they have to look quite ugly, huh?
Yeah, look at these things, they're all haggard. Got mixed match plastic, wheels.
My goodness. Hampshire, Dino, these 15s are old. Are these all 350s?
We got a couple of 250s, yeah, just 350s, so.
Wow.
Yeah.
Breaking day. And you do like just about an hour on each?
Yeah, just about an hour, just enough time to, you know, go through the motions, make sure everything's working good, put some time on it.
Do you have to do heat cycles too or no?
We just ride them, honestly. Like, we take the first few laps a little slow, just make sure everything's working okay, and then we just go do our motos on them.
So if, say, I were to go out and buy a new FC350, what do you recommend I do to break it in?
Yeah, throw a couple of heat cycles in it. When we're setting these up at work, we run a heat cycle through it.
Okay.
Just get it nice and hot. That's how we initialize it. And then after that, yeah, just go cruise it around. You know, take it easy at first, like anything new. You don't want to just go hammer on it right away. But
yeah,
they're pretty good out of the box. So really nothing you got to worry about. Just, you know, a couple of heat cycles and then go ride it.
All right, sick. Yeah.
is up at the tarmac.
I went up the ramp and I just felt like this crazy burn and pop in my leg. And I knew in the air before I even landed, like, that was it.
This championship now is far from over.
How can you handle adversity and make the best out of it?
This is where media bikes come to die.
Dude, who specializes this right here?
Wow. Now she's done.
Pretty much. Who specializes this?
Brandon, this one's mine, right?
Yeah. Look at the old girl.
Dommer, when's the last time you cleaned your filter? Jeez.
That's just from Paul? Friday. Chasing the bro show around.
So this is Dommer's new ride for the week, or for the year. Maybe the year, maybe a couple months again.
Yeah, they'll probably confiscate it for me in about 3 months.
Yeah, just give it time. We'll get it back.
I like the stock graphics much better than your last kit.
This thing's sick.
This thing's sweet. If I recall correctly, this is the new generation KTM frame. Dressed up to look like a husky. Brosho steed. Brosho, say hi to the vlog. Tell us about your white bike. Is that custom?
Hey, vlog. Nope, this is just an MXC5.
And they come in white.
MXC5, and the 5s come in white. The 6s come in red.
Ah.
Brosho wins lit kit of the day.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
Just dialed.
Looks sweet. Even the bottle.
Oh. Yeah, gotta have the gas bottle.
Looks good. And then you got your new intense taser back from being serviced.
Got my super truck driver spring put on. Ready to go.
You replaced the fork seals yet?
Fork seals are all dialed. Look at that, not even using it all.
Wow. You rolling this?
I know.
And I'm missing my button today.
There.
Just follow me. We'll do an underdrive. There's a couple jumps on this one, but they're all rollable. Except this first one, but you can go around it.
Yeah, this is that jump that fence.
Yeah.
Fence? Mm-hmm. You jump over that.
It's not bad.
Go ahead, let's see. Can we can see you going from
there? Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead, let's see.
What's up guys, it is Wednesday morning. Obviously Don's still out of town, but we have to get an SML show filmed or two. So I just set up everything. We have Jet Lawrence's mechanic, Christian Ducharme. I gotta make sure that's how you say his last name right, but he's coming in. I'm stoked. I've always wanted to do an interview with him. Him and I used to ride Harleys together, so it'd be cool to dive in and find out his whole story and how he got to where he is now. So make sure to check that out next Tuesday, which it'll probably already be out by the time this vlog hits. So if you haven't already watched it by the time you're watching this, make sure to check it out. It's definitely gonna be a little weird filming with no one else in here. Ideally, Don's in the host chair and I'm running the audio and the cameras and the boom. But obviously since it's just me, there's gonna be no boom. It's just gonna be stagnant. And then I think I'm gonna have to have Christian sit in both chairs so I can set the focus for each camera. And then I'll probably have to listen to myself and set the audio, which is always weird, but yeah, we're figuring it out. It's not as stressful as I initially thought it was gonna be, so we should be good. Just finished filming for the Swap Moto Live show, and I remembered I had a box from O'Neill to open up, so it is my favorite time of the year as the new gear is dropping really around the next month or so. So O'Neill had their 2025 gear launch on Monday this week. So our boy A-Ray went ahead and sent over some 2025, I believe this is Mayhem gear. Let's see, what does it say? This is, yes, Mayhem. So Mayhem gear, pretty rad. If you know me, you know I love gradients and like the subtle fades from color to color. So this stuff caught my eye for sure. Go ahead and open it up and see how it looks. There she is. Definitely one of my favorite graphics they've had in a while. It kind of looks like the stuff Juju's been wearing where it's orange to the white fade. I've been telling them they need to do more of that, and it looks like they had already been planning on doing some gradient stuff because this has obviously been in the works for the last year or so. So props to the guys, they killed it. There's a lot of cool new colorways and designs for 2025, so if you haven't already, be sure to check it out. It's Thursday morning, happy 4th of July. I managed to get a lot more done than I expected this week, so I'm actually gonna head out to Needles with some buddies for a couple days, and I figured I'd bring you guys along with me. All right, it's like 10 before 5, and we have everything loaded. Ski is bunkered down, hopefully not gonna go anywhere. Got my cooler, geez, that light is really bright, but just trust me, got all my tools, my gas, Maxima Super M Premix, cooler, full 10, some chips, clothes, my OGO, and life vest, so I think we are good to go. What's up guys, it's the next morning. I did a horrible time vlogging yesterday and didn't really touch the camera or anything when I got to the water. Brad and I just woke up pretty early and we're gonna go ride some skis. So I figured I will sacrifice my comfortability of having cool water on my face and wear a helmet so you guys can have some vlog footage. Jet skiing is weird. I think it's kind of a goony thing to wear a helmet and like gloves and all that when you're a goon like me, you know? Like racers, they do it, but I don't know. I'm just a guy that likes going up and down the river, so I think I should just wear a life vest. That's what I normally do. But on the same page, maybe I look like the people that are at the dirt bike track in jeans when I'm just wearing a life vest, so who knows? But yeah, should be fun. It's looking quite glassy out there this morning, so it should be a good time. All right, so for those newbies like Bradford behind the camera, first thing you do is stage at the launch ramp. Oh my god, that's fuller than I expected. You don't want to be doing this on the ramp and causing a traffic jam. Like, it's already. So you go and find a nice parking spot. Do everything you need to do. In this case, fill up. Brad, come show them how much gas we burned yesterday. So, I don't know if you can tell, but this is supposed to be all this color.
Dry as a bone.
Dude, barely made it back. Okay. Bend the shaft. Stick the shaft in the hole. Dump. Alright, this is Brad's new pickup.
Facebook market find.
Pretty good. Solid ski already.
1989
JS. This is a JS. Piston port. Stock as it gets. But she's got like 130 compression or something crazy. So she's mint. Brad already made a rookie mistake though, and he doesn't remember exactly how much gas he put in this can.
Used to the 4-stroke life.
So it's a little bit over 3, so we're gonna guesstimate the premix using some Maxima Super M. I've tried a couple different premixes on my personal ski, and it seems to like this stuff the most for whatever reason, so. Smokeless, that's also a benefit, especially with this guy because his exhaust is going straight for his face. So I've used this a few times for jet skiing. Obviously this is the Bell Full 10. It's their downhill mountain bike helmet. Kind of replicates the Moto 10 that we have nowadays. It just kicks ass. So yeah, this thing's badass. I've used it a couple times for mountain biking out in Whistler and whatnot, but if I'm being honest, I do not go to the mountain bike parks that much anymore. I just ride a lot of local trails. So this thing just sits. So earlier this summer I used it while I was on my jet ski, and it's perfect. It vents a lot better than a Moto helmet, so it keeps you a little cooler, and it's lighter so it doesn't get your neck all sore on the long days. Alright, it's in the afternoon. Bradford just reminded me that I'm not vlogging. Bad at this again. New purchase for the ski. Brad is quickly finding out how there's little subtle issues with something made in the 90s. But you're still in it for how much?
With the battery, probably only 1600.
No, like real, not when you tell your wife number. No. Real number.
It told her way less than that, so 1600. Okay.
That's what we're at. All right, evening session coming soon. Also, I put the GoPro in time lapse for like an hour of our ride earlier this morning, so. We weren't going that fast, actually, sadly. It's only 135 right now. The slight hair dry wind breeze. You got your interesting choice of beverage and your battery.